These are not just cold numbers that exist. They each present the number of deaths caused by a common genetic disease. Is there anything that we can do to prevent these deaths?
What is human genome? Like how computer programs are coded, human genome is the sequence of DNA that codes for Homo sapiens. Gene editing is the programming of DNA. Tiny changes here and there, yet cures for horrible diseases.
There are two types of gene editing. Somatic edits only blood cells and has been tested for over 20 years, while germline, which is relatively new, also edits on reproductive cells. Earlier developed skills for gene therapy are temporary. CRISPR is the main jump in technology in recent days. It's a more efficient tool used to cut genes off with permanent effects. Genes could then be directly inserted, deleted, or substituted at accurate position. So, should we attempt to change the human genome?
The main advantage is the development on gene therapy. Early in 1990, the first gene therapy was approved and has shown improved survival rate in SCID. In 2016, SMA, a once incurable disease, has offered its hope to its patients for the first time. Its first phase of clinical trials on gene therapy was completed. In 3 years under rapid development, a one-time treatment was established. Moreover, muscular dystrophy, ALS, Huntington's disease, etc. have been running its clinical trials. These facts have proven gene therapy to be real and useful, giving hope to patients with fatal illness. However, changes often come with risks. Genes turned on could be hardly turned off. In leukemia gene therapy, patients often experience severe side effects. A study in 2018 has shown that gene therapy could wipe off a whole chromosome, worsening cancers, supporting a case back in 2008. Some of the research requires further development before being approved, yet the mature knowledge towards gene therapy is exactly the reason why we should continue attempting. On the ethical point of view, developing gene editing could be abused by empowered personnel to achieve eugenics. Some may want their child to be smarter, taller, while differences between individuals wouldn't be accepted, causing the abnormal to be stigmatized. However, this is already tackled by a law in 2004 to restrict gene editing on reproductive cells, preventing any inhumane usage of altering basic traits of embryos. Another concern is its cost. Developing a gene therapy requires an estimated cost of $5 billion. Moreover, the cost patients need to bear is overwhelming. Although NICE decided gene therapy would be provided by the NHS, budget is limited. Who gets to decide which patient to be treated? To address this, a clear guideline based on medical figures is published for doctors to use as reference. Moreover, the funding could see an influx as the income brought by such therapies is forecasted $16 billion. Regardless, the high cost for patients on gene therapy outweighs the endless treatment over a lifetime. In conclusion, although gene therapy is still largely in its experimental phase, it has displayed significant progress and potential in treating horrible diseases. It might be presented with several ethical issues, however, clinical progress outweighs them as they can be solved by enforcing regulations.